In this video, we will disassemble the Canon 20D, as far as this picture shows, to replace the compact flash card reader after one of the pins has been bent. First, remove the battery. Then carefully pry off this rubber grip. It is held on by a removable adhesive, and it will stick right back on. Now with a Phillips head screwdriver, remove just these two bottom screws closest to the rear of the camera. We will only need to remove the back cover, and it is now only held on by this screw, the two over the eyepiece, and the one that was hidden behind the rubber grip. Partially lift the back cover, sliding the lip from under the side and swinging it to the other side to reveal the ribbon cable. Detach the ribbon cable and set the back cover aside. All these ribbon cables will need to be detached. This one can be completely removed, but note the orientation that it is in before removing it. Now unhinge each ribbon cable and unplug it from its socket. Pointed spudgers like these are excellent for removing and replacing these cables. Be very gentle with the locking mechanism, as these plastic hinges can break very easily. This is an example of a broken one from a previous owner's repair attempt, and it is failing to provide a proper connection. Also remove this power cord. With your Phillips head screwdriver, remove these three screws on the circuit board. Pull the circuit board aside like this, or just remove it, as I will in a moment. I removed this screw, although I believe it is not necessary to do so. These next three screws actually do hold the compact flash card reader in place. Next, release the ribbon cable for the card reader. Optionally, you may remove this screw connecting the ground cable on the circuit board to remove it. If there are strips of tape here, remove them and gently pull the card reader out of the body. Here you can see the bent card reader pin. The card that caused this will also need to be replaced, or it will continue to damage the new card reader. Now reinsert the new card reader and replace the screws. Reattach the circuit board's ground wire screw. Set the circuit board in place and replace the three screws. This locking mechanism is damaged, and for testing purposes only, I will attempt to force a connection by wedging a strip of paper on top of the ribbon. Now reinsert each ribbon cable, remembering to latch the locking mechanism. Replace this bridge cable and the bottom one, and the power wire. Now you can set the back cover onto the body and attach the final ribbon cable. Close the cover by seating the lip into the side. Reattach this screw, the two over the eyepiece, and the one on the side. Now the final two screws on the bottom can be replaced. Press the rubber grip back onto the camera and make sure it fits into the molded groove. Replace the battery and you're ready to test the camera.